In the last weeks, a lot has been said about the shutdown of French nuclear power plants due to the heat wave. Europe has really been covered by almost the most powerful heat wave in recent decades. In some places the temperature is kept above +40°C. In this video, I will talk about how seriously and on a large scale this affected French nuclear power plants. Let's start with the basics. Yes, nuclear power plants need cooling. Like any thermal power plant that converts the heat of coal, gas or fuel oil into electricity, it needs to condense the steam after the turbines and dump some of the heat into the environment. This is thermodynamics, and you can't argue against physics. Most often, heat is dumped into a body of water, the sea, river, lake or artificial cooling pond. This is called an open circuit. The station takes water from a reservoir, or from a river upstream, and then dumps it downstream, heated by several degrees. This is essentially the third cooling circuit, while the water does not touch the reactor core and is non-radioactive. For the normal operation of a nuclear power plant, the temperature of the cooling water can vary within fairly wide limits. The lower, the better, the cooling will be efficient. But even in the heat, technically, nuclear power plants can work. It's just that if the water is above a certain value, the station will work less efficiently. For example, on this graph, you can see the dependence of the power of the first unit of the Novovoronezh NPP2 on the temperature of the water cooling the condenser. The normal cooling water temperature range is below +31°. When it rises higher, the power of the unit decreases. But back to France and the heat waves. The point is not that nuclear power plants work worse or cannot work in abnormal heat. They can. But there are regulatory requirements so that the temperature of the discharged water does not exceed specific values, so as not to harm the river ecosystem. This is the so-called thermal pollution. And it is with him that the current restrictions are connected. Therefore, in a situation of abnormal heat, some nuclear power plants are forced to reduce power or even stop units so as not to overheat the rivers. The main reason is environmental regulations and concern for nature, not technical problems. At the same time, by the way, exceptions are made for some French nuclear power plants. In agreement with the regulators, they must operate at a certain minimum power to maintain the frequency of the grid even if they exceed the regulations for the discharge temperature. And such deviations from the rules, in my opinion, are the weakest and worst link in this whole story, since damage to the environment can really be caused here. At the same time, the restrictions primarily apply to nuclear power plants located on rivers. 4 of the 18 French nuclear power plants are located on the seashore. These standards and heat waves concern them to a lesser extent. Another 10 nuclear power plants in mainland France use cooling towers for cooling. In them, water evaporates and cools, and heat is directly transferred to the atmosphere, not to river water. With evaporation from the cooling tower, less than 1% of the water is carried away, and the rest goes back to the cooling circuit. Therefore, it is called a closed cooling circuit. Cooling towers need only a small water makeup. This makes it possible to build nuclear power plants even far from large rivers and reservoirs. For example, the Belarusian nuclear power plant practically stands in an open field. Although, in fact, its cooling towers are fed from the river, which is 7 kilometers from the station. But the volume of this water is needed much less than would be needed for open cooling circuit. Or here is the American nuclear power plant Palo Verde, which is generally located in the desert in southern Arizona, and uses water for cooling towers from the wastewater treatment plant in the city of Phoenix for recharge. By the way, in Russia for more than 15 years it has been legally prohibited to use open circuits for new nuclear power plants and thermal power plants. Therefore, all new NPP units built during this time are built with cooling towers. Even the Leningrad NPP2, located on the shores of the Gulf of Finland. But back to France. Only 4 nuclear power plants there are not located on the seashore and do not use cooling towers for all their power units. At the same time, not for all of them, the situation is such that they have a serious impact on these rivers. Most often, the restrictions apply to 3 plants, nuclear power plants Bugey, St. Alban, and Chouz. Nuclear power plant Bugey stands on the banks of the river Rhône. Yes, she has 4 cooling towers, but they only work for 2 of the 4 power units. The first two units of 900 MW use an open circuit for cooling. The second nuclear power plant is St. Alban. It is located downstream on the same river Rhone, so the flow of water in the river is already greater, as is the thermal capacity. But both powerful units of 1300 MW do not have cooling towers. And the third is the nuclear power plant Chuse. On the river Meuse, both of its 1500 MW power units have cooling towers, but the nuclear power plant is located in a patch of France, surrounded by Belgian territory, where the river flows. Therefore, this nuclear power plant has special regulations and requirements for water intake in case of its shallowing in the heat. Other nuclear power plants are usually subject to fewer restrictions. For example, the Tricastin nuclear power plant. It is similar to the Bugey nuclear power plant, two units with cooling towers, two without. But it is located in the more full-flowing part of the Rhone River. However, in this particularly strong heat wave, she reduced power. By the way, an interesting fact is that this nuclear power plant provides energy to the neighboring uranium enrichment plant. So the total carbon footprint of this enriched uranium is very low. In total, about 2 gigawatts of nuclear capacities, or about 8% of their current capacity, were turned off during the current heatwave. This is a lot, but the duration of such restrictions is short. For individual stations, power reduction was carried out over the course of days, and sometimes even hours. On average, since 2000, reductions in the annual output of French nuclear power plants associated with the summer heat amount to about 0.3% of the annual output, although in some years with especially strong heat waves, they can be higher. Most likely this year, too, the figure will be above average. However, the French nuclear power plant operator EDF has a climate adaptation plan for its infrastructure. Well, new nuclear power plants will be built with a margin for cooling. Either by the sea or with cooling towers. Or it will be small modular reactors, for which the issue of cooling and thermal pollution is no longer so relevant. Let me say a few words about the general situation. Currently, about half of all nuclear power plants in France do not generate electricity. But this, firstly, is largely the norm, and I will now explain what I mean. And secondly, it has nothing to do with heat waves. That, however, does not prevent the media from linking all the blackouts with the heat. Let me explain why this is almost the norm. Each nuclear power plant, on average, stops for several weeks once a year for repairs and refueling. Since energy consumption in France is lower in summer than in winter, it is during the summer that nuclear power plants are mainly served. So every third NPP unit is under repair in the summer, and this is up to 15 to 20 units. This is quite normal for France. But what is unusual and really unpleasant is the shutdown of several more units to check technical problems with corrosion, identified last year. At three units, the problem was found and eliminated. At three during the checks, no problems were identified. At another six units, the check was combined with scheduled repairs. All this adds up to a truly unprecedented reduction in nuclear power generation. It is expected that by the end of 2022, the generation of French nuclear power plants may be reduced by almost 20%, to 300 terawatt hours against 360 terawatt hours in 2021. I will add that the heat affects the entire energy infrastructure. Forests are burning and power grids are cut off. Thermal coal and gas power plants also dump heat into hot rivers. In the heat, oil-filled transformers, which are at all power plants and power grids, more often burn. But incidents at conventional power plants do not bother the public so much, so they will not be written about in the media. After all, a burning transformer at a nuclear power plant and at any other plant are two different transformers, in the eyes of the media and ordinary people. Therefore, any incident at a nuclear power plant will certainly be written about in the media, and in foreign ones too. And they will also write about shutdowns of units for any reason, including because of the heat. This gives the impression that everything is so bad. By the way, solar panels also do not like heat, although they love the sun. Not as criticism, but for an objective picture, I will add that the efficiency of panels in abnormal heat can drop by tens of percent. Let's draw conclusions. 1. Yes, the heat has an effect on French nuclear power plants. To a greater extent, it is associated with environmental requirements, rather than technical difficulties. At the same time, this applies to a small number of nuclear power plants, and the total annual decrease in production due to heat is within 1%. 2. Yes, nuclear power plants have an impact on rivers and are a source of thermal pollution. But this situation is regulated. The problem is that sometimes these norms can deviate in favor of the security of the power grid. And it is necessary to watch these cases especially and think about what to do with them. 3. Large nuclear power plants can operate in hot weather and without danger to rivers, with closed circuit and cooling towers. So, it is wrong to say that nuclear energy is vulnerable to climate change. The problem and solutions are clear. Small modular reactors, by the way, and the decentralization of nuclear energy, can also be options for solving the problem. 4. At the moment, the French nuclear industry has problems more serious than heat waves. Technical difficulties in the form of corrosion, regulatory and financial problems, in connection with which EDF has now even decided to completely nationalize. So the heat is their least of a problem. 5. The most important thing, the heat waves that will increasingly occur in Europe due to global climate change affect all infrastructure and all types of energy. So for a reliable energy system, you need a mix of different types of low-carbon energy and not the search for something ideal. There is no ideal, and there are no miracles either. And now you can watch other videos on nuclear topics on the channel. Take care of yourself and your loved ones.